Let's face it, we've become digital hoarders.
I literally got my phone not that long ago, it's already out of storage.
I have never deleted a photo either. I still have of my ex a few years back and everything.
Photos, thousands of them. Emails, apps, documents, Fitbit runs.
The footage for this video?
Stored in the cloud at the push of a button, without really thinking twice about it. But all of this stuff we save lives somewhere in physical spaces, like this one. And they are becoming a major problem for the planet.
Computation in its current form is fundamentally unsustainable.
This is where the cloud lives. In hypersecure,
just drop them in windows.
Yeah. Indiscriminate buildings around the world. This is a particular type of data center called a co-location center, mostly used for businesses. And they want their data accessible at the drop of a hat.
If it goes down, it could mean some data doesn't flow to the health service or the payroll system doesn't work for a company. Loss of revenue, it's very hard to put a physical number on it. It's astronomical, so we never shut down.
Most data centers operate 24/7. And they have backups of backups of backups of backups of our data. And this requires a lot of electricity.
This is the data hall where the customer's data is stored and kept cool. Now I'm standing here and it's really hot. Like I'm sweating, it's 30 degrees Celsius. Because of all the computing and processing that's going on around me, that's generating a lot of heat. And that heat needs to be cooled.
According to Digital Realty, the company reserves about 15 megawatts of power on the national grid for these two data centers, about the same as 6,000 homes. And there are thousands of buildings like these around the world, some of them much bigger than Digital Realty.
If we expand that to include everything that the internet touches, you know, all the devices, all of the data transmission networks, it is something like 2% of global greenhouse gas emissions, which is comparable to the aviation industry.
That was unexpected. I didn't. Wow.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I've never actually thought about it.
I just kind of think it's just online, the cloud. Like, it's not really like a physical thing in my head.
While many of us don't think about the environmental costs of data, some places have to.
Facebook is to invest 200 million euro in
data centers or climate targets.
The company will create hundreds of jobs, although it did not.
Ireland has become a popular location for data centers. About 80 have been built here in the last few decades, and together they use up 18% of the country's electricity. About the same as all urban households in Ireland. This is also a country that is struggling to meet its carbon emission targets, which include reducing its reliance on fossil fuels for its electricity. Fears of blackouts and competing power demands have led the state-owned power provider to block access to the grid for any new data centers. Which might be why the biggest buzzword at this data center conference in Dublin was
sustainability.
Sustainable.
Sustainability.
This year, everyone was talking about how to save energy. Things like using excess heat from data centers and redirecting it to other buildings. Or using water instead of air to cool down the data halls. But that can use up millions of gallons of water per year.
The water-based cooling methods, which significantly reduce the electricity required to cool data centers. The water footprint of data centers is comparable to that of a small town.
Then there are policies that incentivize data center companies, like the one we visited earlier, to fund renewable energy projects that can offset their carbon emissions. Although some say it's handing over too much control of renewable energy to the private sector.
Effectively, that means that they are going to be owning the renewable energy capacity and sources, which isn't going into decarbonizing houses, decarbonizing transport, decarbonizing hospitals. It's decarbonizing data centers.
Simon Cowley's government is obsessed with soaking up to multinational companies
at any cost. It's not being
done. During the conference, a small protest broke out during a government minister's speech, calling for
no more data centers.
A flat-out moratorium on any new data centers being built in the country.
There's so many data centers here already, there's no need to be building anymore, and it makes the already huge task of decarbonizing our energy grid unnecessarily hard.
We can't let big tech just grow in an unfettered way. We have to have regulation.
It's called NIMBYism. Do you want to stop the growth of a digital economy in the world or just in Ireland? Will you accept the economic slowdown that will come with that? Because it will. That's a fact. If the moratorium in Ireland is extended, the infrastructure is going to go somewhere and we do business globally.
I think it's clear, obviously, that we need some data centers, and what's happening is that corporations, big corporations, are being prioritized ahead of our local communities when it comes to these very much public resources like electricity or water.
This question goes beyond Ireland. At what point does data storage become unsustainable? Every year, the amount of data that needs storing goes up by 20%, and that will likely be accelerated with the growth of AI.
We're not talking about streaming cat videos anymore. This explosion in machine learning is going to require far more data.
To solve for this, companies are investing in some pretty out there solutions, like storing data underwater or even in space. Some researchers are looking at storing data in biological DNA, which we're devoting an entire video to in the series. But part of the solution may come down to simply storing less.
We hear talk here of the need for hypergrowth in the industry, driven very much by the machine learning strategies. But why should we be growing this data? Like, show me evidence that the growth of this data and all of the infrastructures and energy and resources it requires is good for civilization.
And while tons of data out there is owned by companies, researchers, governments, etc., it's also down to us, the hoarders, to ask ourselves, do we really need this?
We as consumers of cloud services have become so conditioned to expect constancy, immediacy, and very little interruption. Whenever something isn't available to us instantly, we get frustrated. And I think that is actually cultural. The cloud is using so much energy because it's assuring that that will always be the case.
I don't need those photos, and it produces carbon emission on a regular basis. So delete them if it is.
I'm curious, before you had an iPhone, what would you take photos in the camera?
But it was fun before because you had to wait to get it. We lived in a world where speed was not number one.
Might have.